Good morning, everybody. My name is Steve Zen. I'm from Pac 12, and I'm excited to kick this off. And certainly want to thank Patrick and Professor Rishe and Washington University and the Olin School of Business to have me here today. It's my second time speaking here, so I'm very excited. It's very impressive, this program. My son's best friend actually goes to school here right now. He's a sophomore in the engineering program. I'm not sure if he's here. He won't be here. He's also a runner. And so what I'm doing today is talk about the Pac 12. 5 months, but before that, I spent 20 years at IMG on the West Coast in all areas of sports, you name it, I covered it. UFC, college, fashion, entertainment, culinary, pro sports, what they do. It's a fantastic experience there. And then I worked in tennis for a couple years with the Women's Tennis Association, and was the chief sales officer on a global level for promoting sports, which is important, having two daughters. And then I was recruited by the Pac 12. It's been a fantastic time. I love the college athletic scene. I love the college student experience. And I actually speak every year probably at 5 universities, including Stanford and Cal, in Oregon, on the West Coast, and a couple of other schools in the country. So I think it's really important. Ken made a good point. When I first tried to get into sports marketing, I showed up as an engineer. There was nowhere to go. There really wasn't, I couldn't study that as an undergrad. And so I ended up doing a non-paid internship at IMG. 5 months. I thought it was a complete waste of time. And one day when I was about to leave, they said, hey, you're the best intern we've ever had. I was like, wow, I didn't have very many at that point. And they said, we'd like you to hire you to work at the front desk. We have no other openings, but we'll pay $18,000. You have to open the door, you know. So I actually answered the phones, took notes for people, did whatever was asked by the team. About 9 months, and then they saw something like, hey, we think you're pretty good. Let's make it count. Is that going to be good? So that's where my career started. So I always like to give back and share about how I started and where I am now. So what I'm going to do is I asked Patrick, what do you want me to talk about today? And he said, one thing that we don't cover too much is sales. Anybody out here interested in sales? It's a very generic term. Okay, there's a few. So I've learned over time that selling is something you do every single day. Okay, all walks of life. Consultant, whether you are selling yourself in an interview, whatever you're doing, you're talking about yourself and you're capable of your skill sets. And so don't ever be afraid to sell or get experience in selling, because I think it's going to always carry moving forward in your life. All right, so what I'm going to do is talk about the Pac 12. In 5 months, I've learned a lot. We're a pretty awesome property, so I'm going to share with you all the great things. But at the same time, I'm going to talk more a little bit look under the hood to talk about what am I really facing from a reality perspective, or the challenges, okay, in selling a property like the Pac 12. And this could be true for any property you talk about that you can develop someday, that there's always the good, which you're always going to see when someone's presenting, but then there's a lot of stuff underneath that actually has to be worked on and worked through to actually be successful in the sales market. All right, so let me see if I get this going. This is a new presentation that we work with called Channel 1, which is actually pretty neat because it's very nice. All right, so what is the Pac 12? I'm going to leave with, one second, a little, 4 minutes. All right, Eddie, do you have to cue that? Thank you.
Something about going to war with your brothers every Saturday 12 times a year. What do you lose? You've got your actions.
Sometimes adversity is like the best thing you need.
When I'm out there on that field, it feels like I have no worries.
You know, the character of our team needs to be strong.
We are here! And it's time to get fired up!
Open up! Let's go! Focus on what you're doing. That's what good football teams do.
Washington's gonna have the most balls!
In the pursuit of perfection, you find excellence.
That is such a great feeling that goes beyond sports.
have 10 more videos I can share with you, but I'm not going to be able to do that right now. Okay, so this is a pretty comprehensive deck. I'm just going to share with you how I would pitch the Pac-12. Pretend you're a brand. So I'm coming out, and I'm going to tell you, okay, all the things that we do that actually make you want to associate with us, starting with our schools, 12 universities, pretty prestigious ones when you look at it in the footprint, truly covering the West Coast. And you look at Stanford, Cal, Washington, UCLA, SC, really big schools, academic-wise as well as sports-wise. Pac-12 legends, any conference could do this, but we certainly have some spectacular athletes who have graduated from our schools, including Tiger, who was in the previous video, Aaron Rodgers, Clay Thompson, and among others. Impressive list. When you look at the Conference of Champions, which is what we call ourselves, you look at the number of championships we've actually won across any sport, women, men, and combined, we're clearly at the highest level. Our footprint, when you look at the 25 biggest metros in the United States, 7 of them are in our footprint on the West Coast. So if you're a brand that's trying to reach the West Coast, this is a good way to actually build your brand around that and associate with us. Okay, then you look at the number of companies, and you look at the GDP, and all the business that actually takes place on the West Coast is pretty impressive. And all these companies here have been founded by alumni of Pac-12 schools. Okay, this is an amazing stat that I came up with. When you look at the GDP, a lot of it is driven by California as well as Washington State. The GDP of our 6 states, it would actually equal to be number 4 on a global level compared to any country in the world, which is pretty amazing. So again, we're tapping into that as a brand. If you want to associate with a lot of business and commerce, the West Coast is a good place to be. Okay, this one is almost too high, oftentimes when I meet brands, but this is an example of we're meeting with Rolex. We talk about household income over 150. We talk about education beyond being an undergrad. We skew so high across almost any other property we look at. Okay, and then we have our championship football game that we run every December at Levi Stadium where the 49ers play. And then we have our basketball tournament in Vegas. This year will be March 11th through the 14th. That leads into whoever wins that tournament has an automatic bid to the March Madness. All right, so a couple things that are unique to the Pac-12 that I've talked about are we have our own network, which is rare. Most of the conferences, if you look at the ACC, you look at the Big Ten, they have sold their rights from a media perspective to either ESPN or Fox. We've actually decided to keep it. We actually own 100% of it. And the way it works is we're a nonprofit, 12 universities, each of 1/12 owners and decision makers in anything we do. So what we have because of that is we go at it ourselves. And what that means is we have our own, let's see here, overview here. We have 7 basically channels that we run. We have a national channel for our big events, and then we have 6 regional ones, one for each of the states where our schools are, except for Colorado, Union, and Utah, we have a mountain channel. So what happens is we can customize content, produce 850 shows a year around sports content, and we can then distribute it to the key markets where people are actually interested in. And what we've learned is that's neat because we own all that content and we think it's very valuable. To Kent's point earlier about live content, it's probably the most rich and most viable content out there today, particularly in sports. And so we feel pretty strong that because we own all of our content, we're going to be able to continue to monetize that for a long time. We have a digital platform. We have a lot of people. We have an app that we're pushing called Pac-12 Now. We have we push people to watch it because we are seeing a decline in the people that actually watch linear television, including many probably in this room. Okay, so the only other one I want to cover is a couple things that are unique to us, which I'm a big believer in, is we do have a couple platforms that we are playing at. One is our Women's Sports Initiative. We
Because we win a lot of championships in women's sports, we've developed a platform where you as a brand, as an example, we're talking to Uber right now. They're trying to create some additional messaging around safety, particularly when targeting women. So we're looking at doing a program with them where they can become the presenter of all of our women's sports. And then we can create customized messaging to tie those two together in a relevant way. So that's pretty unique for us with a women's platform. We also have an Olympic platform. It's interesting, with the Olympics coming up in Tokyo, which will be very big, we have also a stat where we have more Olympians from the Pac-12 as a country. I think we'd be number 5 on a global country level as far as winning medals. So we develop a bunch of programming depending on what athletes actually qualify around that leading into Tokyo and then afterwards. And the last program that we have, I think is unique to our conference, is around sustainability. And this is something that no other conference does right now. And I think it's pretty neat because, find it here, it's all about conservation, it's about green. I'll just talk to it. But it's really unique that we are trying to, and we started this, and then our schools are embracing this too. We're coming up with a program that actually talking about zero waste, carbon emissions, and things like that. And so now every school is embracing that, and we do a program every year in leading that. All right, so what I'm okay, that's, now who's interested in the Pac-12 now? You probably learned a little bit today? A little bit? Any Pac-12 fans? A few here? All right, so this is how we pitch this. We just talk about this on the upfront. And if I were selling to someone like an Uber, I would do a call with probably someone very senior there first, and then I would customize this based on what they're trying to do from a business marketing perspective. All right? So not it's fun, it's good, and again, it's very exciting stuff. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch gears and have Eddie pull up another slide that talks about what I'm really doing. As a good salesman, you play up your key selling properties, your key success factors, and things like that. And then on its flip side, you deal with the things that are challenges in the marketplace. Something that you see or you hear in the marketplace once you're pitching. And this is where I call on the second slide, this is the reality check. And this is where, this is what keeps me awake. This is why I lead the team. And this is why I have to figure out how do we combat these things. The first one that's going to come up is distribution. The challenge is there. Mono, are you here right now? Mono's an expert. Okay, he's an expert. He's been working at Fox for years here in St. Louis. I actually call him all the time for help. But there's a deterioration in people actually watching broadcast television. That's a problem for anybody that actually puts programming on TV. So what's happening is you have cord cutting as part of that. And you also have a challenge with that audience of 18 to 35-year-olds. How do we reach them? My son's 19, he doesn't watch TV, but he sees every single highlight. He's never missed one I have. So when I say, hey, did you see that Seth Curry shot? Oh, yeah, I saw that. So that's, well, how do we reach those folks is a really important thing for us and for any property. We have an issue with national regional. Is it Pac-12? Are we truly a national property? Or are we a regional property? I presume we're regional. But you know, a lot of people in our building said, no, we're national, we're huge. One of our challenges, we have late games. We have games that start at 8 o'clock Pacific or 7 o'clock, which is 11 o'clock East Coast time. Nobody's going to watch that. That's a challenge, right? Okay, the other one that always hits me is constantly get compared to the SEC, the Big Ten, and the ACC. And particularly SEC, because they win so much, and the Big Ten, which is an amazing football, right? Again, back to my earlier point, we're different. So we can't keep trying to compare with them, so we have to talk about why are we great, what are we that's different, and why you should associate. Fans in our footprint, as an example, I was talking to someone yesterday in your room, Stanford, when they were really good with Andrew Luck and Christian McCaffrey, the last number of years, fans still wouldn't go to Stanford Stadium to watch a game because they had too many choices with their leisure time. It's amazing. You wouldn't see that in other markets, particularly SEC. Same thing with corporate brands. They have so many options on where should they spend their dollars. Do they go to the Warriors? It's pretty safe bet. Do I go with the 49ers who are winning on the West Coast? Pretty safe bet. The Galaxy, the Football Club, the Raiders, all new stadiums. So all those things compete with us for marketing dollars. And then this is an interesting one. I'm not sure how, I'll get into the weeds real quick, on 12 universities. Our 12 schools, as much as we work with them every day, they have sold their third-party rights to other companies like IMG, Learfilm, Fox, or they do it on their own. Anytime we try to negotiate benefits for our partners, we have to go to Action Course Training with the schools. And that's not always easy because that's an ongoing battle. And then the other one that's important is whenever I pitch Pac-12 to somebody, they always say, oh gosh, can I get your students? Can I get your alumni? That's who's most desirable. How do you actually do that? Is not that simple. Alumni are very protective, even here in WashU, of their list. Students, you can't just target them like you want to. So you have to be very smart and thoughtful in actually how you do it. And then SB 206, I'm sure many of you followed that. It's the whole idea of paying athletes. Passed in California, it won't happen until January 2023. So I think a lot's going to happen between those 3 years of where this nets out on a national and a local basis. the last one I just threw out there, it's not on there, it got cut off, was if we want a little more, particularly in football and men's basketball, my job would be a lot easier, ratings would be higher, and all those kind of things. But unfortunately, I'm a runner, I'm not a coach, I don't play football, so I can't actually control that. So this gives you a little sneak under the hood of what I deal with every day. Front end was easy, coming up with why we're great. The most important part is coming up with how do we fix these things and have answers for these when we receive rejections in the marketplace. And that's how we sell. But it's a fantastic entity. I love it, and I'm really happy to be there. On that note, I'm going to finish up here. And thank you all for having me here, and hope I could share a little bit on how you sell.
Questions for Steve before he... Questions for Steve?
Yeah.
Questions in the back?
There's one here, too.
Okay.
It's a good question. It's very good. So the question was, how do you, because we have East Coast starting times that are late, how do you combat that? My viewpoint is, and talking to many people, we're never going to get them if they don't want to come, right? We'll get the alumni who live in New York, Boston, East Coast. So we know they're going to find us. They'll seek us out. Don't worry about the rest. They'll come if we start winning more. So if SC starts winning, UCLA wins, Oregon wins, we think we'll get them. I prefer, let's just continue to get increased engagement in our footprint so that when we sell to a brand, say, hey, if you want the West Coast, you should come talk to us. That's actually how I'd argue. I don't think we should spend all the money and time trying to build up our fan base on the East Coast because they didn't go to school on the West Coast. Yeah, good question.
Meredith? How is SB 206, how are you guys dealing with it internally as a conference?
Which one? I'm sorry?
The new bill, the California bill.
Oh, yeah, SB 206. Okay, so is this off the record?
Everything in here
is this? All right. I thought about this.
Down.
Yeah, I've thought about it. I don't want Larry Scott, our commissioner, to get out of here. Now, I think I've thought about this for 10 years now, in speaking and seeing how much money is poured into college athletics. The thing that's interesting is, do I think they should get compensation? Yes. Now, when you're a full scholar athlete, the compensation is pretty high if you think about it. It's beyond just tuition. At the same time, if you really peel back, and you work in talent, Meredith, with Tana, and she's going to speak, if you look at a triangle of the number of people that actually, athletes that get deals, and Kent, you know this, at the highest level in any sport, it's very, very small. It's tiny. And so even at the collegiate level, you're going to have a Zion every once in a while, a few other great athletes, but the majority aren't going to make it to the pro ranks. So they might be able to get some small dollars in college for a limited time, but most aren't going to make it to the pros. It's just so hard. So it's going to have to give. I think the NCAA has to definitely get involved and come up with something. I'm worried that if we don't have a national regulated program here, each school, each conference is going to do it differently, which I think is going to be a real cluster. This is, we're early in this. This is like, barely first quarter. We're nets out. Okay, any other questions?
All right, thank you, Steve.
Thank you. Yeah.